Started out, Freeze and I were fucking Comedy Store veterans, man, and yeah. That was a place that nobody patrolled. There was no manager shushing the room. Just the Comedy Store was run by the guy on stage, and occasionally dudes got kicked out because the comic would go, "Just get these fucking people out of here, God damn!" It would get to the point where it was just you had to kick them out before the show couldn't go on. But there was always something there. That place is always drama. I've had glasses thrown at me on stage there. Remember when Holtzman got knocked out by Martin Lawrence's bodyguard?
We were just talking about that.
That place was chaos.
I remember I remember Eddie Griffin. We were in the main room. We had a show. It was Martin Luther King's birthday. And after the show, this was when a DJ came on. This is the first time I heard the song No Vaseline.
Right.
Remember that?
Yeah.
And the DJ played it, and Dr. Dre and all of the Dog Pound. And
it was about Dr. Dre.
Yeah, they were all there, and Dre went up on stage and snatched the record off the turntable and snapped it in half. And that kicked off a riot. Tretch was in there. Tupac was in there. Tretch had that big chain with the padlock on it. He was swinging that over his head.
Oh, my God.
All of this went on in the May Room on Martin Luther King's birthday.
Wow.
I remember that.
Holy shit.
Man, my scene,
that place was fucking crazy, man.
His last wife, Flynn. Yeah. Richard Pryor's last
wife. Oh, yeah,
Flynn.
Yeah.
Seen the wettest woman out there, boy.
At the Comedy Store?
Comedy Store. I was in the parking lot. Richard Pryor was performing that night. And she was standing by the back door, and this other chick came around, was getting ready to come up. And they knew each other, obviously. She said to that other chick, "Didn't I tell you not to come to no more Richard's shows?" Pop. Every time she hit another piece of jewelry came off. So when she got finished, all of this woman's rings and necklaces and everything and her wig was laying on the floor.
Wow.
And they was dragging her away, man. And then Richard Pryor went on stage and did 20 minutes on what just happened. Classic, sir. Took it straight to the stage.
He went right on the stage with it?
Straight to the stage.
Oh, man. What year was this?
That had to be in the 80s, man. You're like 89, 90, something like that.
Could you imagine if you fucking videotaped that?
It's a long time ago.
Wow.
Can you imagine if you had a videotape of that?
No one was expecting that. That was like on the moment. She said, "Didn't I tell you not to come no more to Richard's shows?" Just started firing on him.
How beautiful would that video be to watch that? Watch the ass kicking, to ass Pryor kick. Walking on stage, to just Pryor talking about the ass kicking.
It went all
pre show. You don't want to miss it.
I performed
it. 20 minutes on what just happened outside.